We continue with the mimer that was said on the fifth night of Hanukkah, which is today, Parshas Miketz, in 1970. And Roni Vesimchi, that's the second part, the second mimer that was said with this title, Roni Vesimchi, by the Rebbe. And that year, on that year, he said two mamorim, Roni Vesimchi. So we'll start with Daf Yud at the Mevayot Samach Tzedek, which is on line 4. Svarsek explains, Shekedei Shibnei Yisrael Yuch Leachzik Marit Begolus Mitzrayim. In order for the Jewish people to be able to handle Golus Mitzrayim, the exile of being in Mitzrayim, the famous saying, Makdim, this is the last week.
Right.
It's this famous saying here, this one. Makdim Refuah L'Makkah. What does it mean, Makdim Refuah L'Makkah? The many times Hashem provides the healing before even the sickness comes along. Right?
Yeah.
With COVID, there was a little bit.
No, it was there.
It was there. They just didn't want to use it.
Right.
That's a different story. Yeah. I agree with you. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah. So
and the thing they used came before the malaria, quinine, which is in the trees.
It also came before.
Right. And that's the same thing. So
what the four did Hashem provided before we went down to Mitzrayim? He sent Yosef. Yosef was there.
You're line 5 now, I think.
Thank you.
So,
the cure was there. Was Yosef was there to enable us to sustain this godless, to handle this godless. Why did we need help, the help of Yosef? So because Mitzrayim is called Erva Sa'oretz. Mitzrayim is a place of nakedness, spiritual nakedness. Spiritual, a place of immorality, promiscuity, all the negative things you can think about, and which seemingly is the only place that is called like this. Ervas Ha'oretz, the nakedness of the earth. It says that when Avraham Avinu is traveling to Mitzrayim, he has to lie about his wife, right? He says she's my sister. So Rashi says over there that what runs in their blood, it's like he's comparing them to horses in terms of their desire, that they, as soon as a person comes, she's your wife, she's your sister, who is she? Like he's right. Not in the picture at all. It's like,
we'll check your passport.
So in order for that to happen, meaning in order for the Jewish people to go down to such a lowly place spiritually, we first needed to have Yosef went down, was taken down to Mitzrayim. In line 7, it says, "Befortius yesh b'zeh shnei inyanim." Line 8, there's two things about it. Deina lechol rosh. Initially, Yosef tzricha leyosiridas hashchinot od lifnei tchilas hagolus. He says, physically, Yosef went down to Mitzrayim, but in order for Golus to take place, something else needed to happen. Meaning the Shechina itself, the Divine Presence, needed to be somewhat degraded. Yeridas HaShechina, or lifnei tchilas hagolus. Meaning before the Golus even started, the Shechina had to somewhat be degraded. Sheharei tchilas hagolus tabiridas Yaakov Mitzrayim. Says, when did actually the Golus started? When Yaakov came to Mitzrayim in Parshas at the end of Parshas Vayigash.
But we're counting from before.
We're counting?
From Yitzchak, when the Akedah or something.
Well, like. that's because Hashem said to Avram, Yadoa Teida, that your children, you should know that your children are going to be 400 years in Eretz Lo Eloim, in a land that is not theirs, and so on. So that's for the 400, but the 210 years,
okay.
That actually they were in Mitzrayim. Some say from the birth of Yitzchak they started the count. But that's to count for the 400 years that were told to Avram. But the Redu is the 210,
right.
Is only the time that they actually occupied Mitzrayim. So the Tchilas HaGolus was when Yaakov is going down to Mitzrayim. And by the way, the Torah needs to tell Yaakov, I mean Hashem tells Yaakov, which is recorded in the Torah, that not to be worried about going down to Mitzrayim. Why? Because he understood that if I'm going to Mitzrayim, then the Golus is starting. Up till now, it was my kids going back and forth, bringing, but the moment that he himself is now going to live in Mitzrayim, that's the beginning of Golus.
Game changer.
Yeah. And when is the truly, truly Golus starting? Is when Yosef passes away. When this, the generation, the brothers of Yosef, Yosef himself, Yosef by the way was the first one to pass away, 110 years. But before all these stages that took place, Shechina needed to be, first they have to have Yiridas Shechina. That the Shechina had to go through various levels of descent. Ad shezekva hoyo b'imei Yosef. This already was done in the days of Yosef. Kasher Yosef v'ol Mitzrayim, when Yosef was taken down to Mitzrayim. Kedeita v'zoya. The Zoya Parshas Re'ei tells us. Zoya Chelek Aleph. He says she Yosef v'bechinas yesod elyon. What Yosef represents spiritually? The Yesod, the foundation, and if you know it, the emotive attributes are also divided in the physical body. So the Yesod is the foundation of the body, and that's where Yosef was tested all the time. His trials were with the Yesod. So, but spiritually, that's on a physical level. There's a novi that says, "Chadorim bedas yemaleu." Rooms will be filled with knowledge. What does that mean? That if you have a house, empty house, you need to put furniture. So, where do you put the furniture? So you have to use your mind saying, okay, this is where I want the kitchen to be, this is where I want the living room to be. So it's, each room is also associated with certain midah. So I said, what is the kitchen? Now start with the living room.
Cooks.
The living room is a place of chesed because you have guests on the table. Right, chesed. Kitchen is gevurah. Listening to the speech, I asked Elvis, so what is the bedroom? So he said it's the Yesod.
And he said, I knew you were going to ask that question.
He didn't. I wanted to know two things, the kitchen and the, so he said kitchen, I said, why is it good? Well, I said the knives. You're chopping down. Where would usually the people be like nervous in the kitchen? It's a place where you have to create.
Dining room is also chesed.
No, he said the dining room is chesed. Dining room, living room. Yeah, oh, that's a place for people dining. You're having guests in your table. In Central Village, I don't know if you have both. Living room and dining room. Or it's one place.
Well, we have a dinette and a living room. Okay. I have three distinct areas that all meld into one. Each is distinct.
Yeah, so it says Shelo Chanikra Yosef HaTzadik. Why was Yosef called HaTzadik and not Reuven HaTzadik, Shimon HaTzadik, Levi HaTzadik, Yehuda? Why is only Yosef called HaTzadik? So it says Al Shem Midosei VeAvodosei, because of his Midah, the Midah of Yesod, and Avodosei, that he was able to withstand the test. In the famous story with Potiphar, and we read Posach Eliyahu every Friday afternoon, and if you notice, we said over there, Yesod, Siyuma de Gufa, Ois Bris Yosef. Yesod is the culmination of the body, Ois, the sign of Bris, of covenant of Yosef. You know, next time you read it, pay attention to these words. Ois Bris Kodesh, the Bris Kodesh, not Bris Yosef, Bris Kodesh. That's the words you'll see.
Yosef,
no. So, but we know the Yosef is Yesod. Velochen, or Yisrael Shechina, and that's why the Shechina was with him. Al derech ze, b'chol echad mi'Yisrael, within every single, usually, it's actually very unique, because in Chabad, Chabad teaching, they don't speak, in Breslov, it's very common, they speak about the concept of the bris, the Yesod, the importance of guarding it. But over here it says it. Ve'al derech ze, b'chol echad mi'Yisrael, sh'al dei netiras bris kodesh, azay Shechina imo. You want the Shechina to be with you? Netiras bris kodesh is by making sure that you're remaining holy. Let's put it in these words. Okay, so Yosef merited the Shechina was with him because that he mastered his Yetzer in regard to that. V'yoda ima Mitzrayim, and the Shechina descended with Yosef to Mitzrayim. V'inyan ze. And this was a preparation. That was a preparation. Not only that the Jewish people are not going to be immersed in the exile of Mitzrayim, that they should have the ability to do venitzaltem with Mitzrayim, to elevate Mitzrayim, to extract all the sparks that were in Mitzrayim, to take advantage of Mitzrayim, not to have anything left there spiritually that needed to be worked with. So what gave them the power of venitzaltem at Mitzrayim, to, I'll call it the harsh words, to abuse Mitzrayim, what gave them the power to do it, obviously spiritually, it's Yosef, and moreover, it's the Shechina that came down with Yosef. Why the Shechina came down with Yosef? Because he mastered his Yesod. So, and why did it to begin with? They went down to Mitzrayim to prepare, to help the Jewish people, to help the Jewish people to deal with the exile of Mitzrayim. Yeah, so, oh, no?
So I'm wondering if the Jews coming down into America is also the same idea, to grab any sparks that are here?
Of course.
And the ultimate person, in that case, was to receive the Torah here,
it's
to receive Mashiach's kingdom.
It says in Tehillim, Mehashem mitzadei gover koinonu, that all the steps that we take are all from Hashem already. So the reason why you live in certain places, you encounter certain people, it's all because of the sparks that you specifically have to elevate. You and no one else can do. And that's why we're living in the place that we're living. We think, oh, we decided to live here.
My wife decided.
She told the chiddush is that she didn't even decide. Oh, no, minyan ze, eino maspika dain, sharei, tzorch lios gam minyan ge'ulo begashmas kipshuto. You said that obviously this doesn't satisfy us. Why it doesn't satisfy us? Because we still want to have a complete redemption, not halfway. Okay, Yosef helped us to go through the exile of Mitzrayim, but we want to be completely redeemed. צריך להיות גם עניין הגאולה בגשמיות כפשוטו. It needs to be done on a simple level. ובירור כל העניינים גם בגשמיות. Everything that needs to be elevated should be elevated. So despite, on top of the Shechina descending in the time of Galut, Amen. We needed Yosef to dominate Mitzrayim. And that's what he did. Mibiladecha, it says, without you, lo yarim ish et yado v'et raglo, no one was allowed to raise their hands or feet. Ve'ad, sheYosef liket et kol hakesef hanimtza Mitzrayim. It says, Yosef gathered all the money that was in Mitzrayim. Ribui gadol umuflag shel kesef v'zav mikol ha'olam. Money, silver, and gold from the entire world was given to him. Why? Because they needed to buy food. The whole world suffered of starvation, and they had famine in the world in general. So they all came to Yosef and bought him the money. So it was... almost like with Shlomo HaMelech, it says the difference between Shlomo and David, that Shlomo was able to bring everyone to him. So it, instead of David HaMelech had to go to wars and elevate them and deal with the evil, Shlomo would attract them. Yosef did the same thing. Seems like Shlomo HaMelech copied Yosef. Because he caused everyone to come to him. Ultimately, why did Yosef gather all the money? That it should circulate within the Jewish people. Shenikreu al shem Yosef. It says, Noheg katzon Yosef. The Jewish people are called after Yosef because he sustained them in the time of famine. Umosif atzemach zeg davar shekedei la'avtiach et klalut inyan galut Mitzrayim. And in order to secure that even though we are in Galut, even though we are in Galut Mitzrayim, the Jewish people should still receive what they needed to receive. Pa'al Yosef, Yosef made sure shagam biyoto be'ot Mitzrayim, that even when he's in Mitzrayim, tachat memshelat paro, under the domination of paro. Sha'af al pi, Yosef was a mishne l'melech, was a viceroy to the king. Biladecha, somehow he was able to impart or to impact. Biladecha lo yarim eshet yado v'traglo, that no one was allowed to raise their hands or feet without the permission of Yosef. Famous midrash that tells us that how Yosef conducted himself with those who came to buy food. He took their money, and when they ran out of money, he said to them, "Give me your do something to justify me giving you food." So he wanted them to circumcise. I'm feeding you, so circumcise. So they didn't want. They went to complain to Paul. So Paul said to them, "I don't understand." When he saw the dreams, initially, everybody knew that he was going to have 7 years of famine. Why didn't you save food? So he said, "We did save food." So this is what happened to him. "Why don't you eat your own food?" He said, "It rotted." So he said, "How come your food rotted, his food did not?" He also stored the food. He didn't use different methods of storage. He stored food, you stored food. You rotted, his didn't. So Paro said, he decreed that your food would rot and his food would not. So you have to follow what he tells you to do. So he made them circumcise. And afterwards, he made them slaves. Because he made sure to shift them from their land, right? Relocated everyone, so they never feel owners of the land. So really dominated the world. Biladecha lo yarim ishet yado vedro mikol makom. Rak hakiseh egdal mimeka, that's what Paro tells them. Tiyam shechat hashefa lo al yedei ha'shivim sarim. So then over here, he tells us, he takes us even to us on a spiritual level, how the Yosef Rabbeinu, Yosef HaTzadik, secured the flow to Am Yisrael. He writes that he doesn't want the Shefa, the flow, to come through the 70 ministers. We know there's a concept of 70 ministers, the 70 nations of the world. That's why on Sukkot, we bring 70 bulls to have Ashpa'ah, to have a flow to the nations of the world. Ve'afilu lo al yedei asar shel Mitzrayim. Yosef didn't want any of the flow to come through the 70 ministers or the minister that is in charge of Mitzrayim. We're talking about the spiritual flow. Ki'im al yedei ha'shchina ben tzot Yosef. He wanted everything to come through the Shechina. To come from a pure source. K'mo she'katuv, Yosef hu ha'mashbir bar l'chol ha'maratz. Yosef, he's the one that the flow went through him. Umuvan, even to the nations of the world. He wanted it to come through him. Umuvan shakavana bze, ilorak lashpa le Yaakov uvanav, shaitaz elakepashuta ktuvim, shashpa lechol Mitzrayim. The flow to the entire Mitzrayim was through Yosef, not through the 70 ministers or the minister of Mitzrayim. Ale de ze shevaitzbo Yosef bar, by him gathering this crop, this produce, everything that he was gathering, the grain. And when the Egyptians were crying out to Paro, Amar lehem, Paro, lechu el Yosef. Paro himself said, "Go to Yosef." Aynu shegam Paro da, even Paro admitted, shebezman hazeh na'aset ha'ashpa'at kol ha'im al yedei Yosef. He himself said, the Ashpa, the flow that comes to the world right now, it's through Yosef. Right. We said it before you came. Yeah. But he writes that Tchilat HaGalut Hayta Beyiridat Yaakov LeMitzrayim, and really, really the Galut started when the tribes passed away. When everyone passed. It says, Vayamat Yosef V'chol Echav V'chol Ador Ahu. Yosef passed away, his brothers, the entire generation. And then it says, Vayakar Melech Hadash Al Mitzrayim. A new king arose that didn't recognize or didn't want to remember what Yosef was. And that's really where the Galut kicked in. But spiritually, it started way before. Because Yosef brought the Shechina with him to Mitzrayim. So the Shechina was in exile. And that's how it all started. ויש לו אוסיף בזה על פי הפירוש השני במה שכתוב הכיסא אגדל ממכה. What does it mean? Just a power when he tells Yosef, you are in charge. He says to him, רק הכיסא אגדל ממכה. Just the throne will be greater than you. Everything else will be inferior to you, but the throne will be great. So it says שגם כאשר כל העניים שכים על ידי יוסף, even at the time that everything goes through yourself, all the flow is coming through yourself. Akise gdal mimeka, what does it mean? Akise shel paro dekdusha sheminet pariu kol neurin. This is amazing. It says there's paro of klipa and there's paro of kedusha. Meaning paro of klipa, which means paro of the other side, and paro of holiness. So paro is lashon oref, right? Paro lashon oref. To represent stubbornness, to represent negative things, right? But parov kedusha, the Zohar, right? Minei itpariu kol neurin, that from him there is all the revelations of light are coming from parov kedusha. Kedeita b'zohar shezoi darga bekedusha shelemala mikol medida v'akbala. The Zohar says that the parov kedusha is a level that is above any limitation. Revelation that is above any kinds of limitations. It says that all the spiritual flows that are coming to a child is after Brit Milah, after the Pri'ah. Pri'ah otiot paro, right? We say Pri'ah is in the Moyal terminology, or even in Hebrew, Pri'ah is to reveal something, to remove something. So after the Priya, after the Parov Kedusha, and now the child is exposed to his name, to the spiritual energy that comes with him, to all the blessings that comes along with him, or comes to him. But the idea of Priya is to reveal, to remove the concealment.
Rabbi, how come we have two versions? As I always heard in Portuguese, or even in English, Paro. But in the Torah, I see sometimes it's both, it's Paro and Pharaoh.
Right, but that's a laws of Diktu. There's many, it's many instances. It's not only with Paro and Pharaoh. It comes so many times. I mean, that's one of the things that makes it difficult that we have it. Actually, somebody once asked the Rebbe, what difference does it make if I say Paro or Pharaoh? It's the same person. So the Rebbe answered him, what's your last name? And that was his answer. Because his last name was Fisher. So the Rebbe told him, what's your last name? So if you say Fisher with an F, Faro, it's fine. But if you say Pei, it's a Fisher. And that's a negative way of saying it. The idea is that there is, obviously, there are differences, but sometimes the pay has to be emphasized, sometimes the chet has to be emphasized, sometimes the ayin has to be emphasized. That's the shvana, the laws of diktuk, of grammar. Why sometimes you have to put an emphasis on a certain letter, sometimes on the last letter. It's got also something called mil'el and mil'ra. Milra is that the emphasis has to be on the last letter, and that's milra, and milel is the letter before, right? We had it in last week parasha where it says, but Roshcha or Roshecha. Roshcha and Roshecha. One is Milel, one is Milra. So
it's single and then plural. No?
No. No, not Rashechem. Not Roshechem. It was Roshcha or Roshecha. It depends where the it's the vowels. It's where the there's a segel there, but it depends what the segel is. But that's where but the idea is, Paro is not all what we think. Or it says that Moshe Rabbeinu himself was afraid to deal with Paro. Parashat Bo, it says Bo el Paro. So Rashi says, you're not going by yourself. I'm going with you. Why? Because he was worried about Paro. Why? Because according to the Zohar, Paro had a lot of power. Power of Klipa and power of Kedusha. Both of them were very strong. So it in the Zohar, he calls them Atanin HaGadol HaRovetz B'toch Yorav, which means the great serpent or the great alligator that is crouching in the Nile. That's how they call the Paro. So, V'kevan sh'itpariu kol ne'urim. Since he is the source of light that has no limitations, so we can have this revelation even in Mitzrayim, even in a place that is called the nakedness of the world. So now we understand why he says, "Rak hakiseh gdal mimeka," only the throne will be greater than you, because the throne is representing already power. Power of Kedusha that would bring unlimited light. We said in the Agadah that the departure out of Mitzrayim was not done by any agents, not angels, not messengers. It was done by Hashem Himself. And it says in the writings of the Arizal about Yetziat Mitzrayim, She'ilu haya olech sham malach, if an angel was sent to take us out of Mitzrayim, you wouldn't believe the statement. In elozo bilvad shelo hayta b'yichoto legolot Yisrael, not only that he would not be capable of taking us out of Mitzrayim, he himself would be drowning there. If Hashem would have sent an angel, it says, Ela yesh chashash, there is a concern, shaya nishka ba'atzmo sham, he himself would get stuck there. Why? Mipnei ha-tum'a shayita b'rvat Mitzrayim, because of the impurity, high level, saturated impurity in Mitzrayim.
Yeah, we were at the last level.
Didn't we have
level.
The angels in Sodom too? They went in with Lot in his house.
Yeah, but Sodom is Eretz Yisrael, it's not Mitzrayim. The Dead Sea, right? You've been there. Yeah. That's part of Eretz Yisrael. So it says, "V'lachen u'tzricha l'tetziad Mitzrayim al edei Hakadosh Baruch Hu v'chodo v'atzmo." That's why he himself needed to get involved in taking us out of Mitzrayim. U'mizeh muvan, and from that we can understand she'davka mitzad bechinat minei itpar'u kol ne'urim. The level of Paro, that from him the lights, the Paro of Kedusha, that from him the revelations of limitless light are coming, shelamala mikol medidah v'hagbalah, yecholah liot shvirat galut Mitzrayim. So power is really saying, on the simple level, power is telling Yosef, you do everything, you are in charge, just don't forget that I am the king. The throne is greater than you. On a spiritual level, he says to him, everything is from you, the flow is coming to the world through you. Physically, you are in charge. Everything comes through you, not 70 ministers, not the minister of Mitzrayim, it comes through you. But remember that this is the exile of Mitzrayim, we need something greater than even you. What is it? The power. What is the power of Kedusha? The unlimited light. And it tells him that Yecholah Liot Shvirat Galut Mitzrayim, to break the exile of Mitzrayim, needs to be done through the Kiseh, the throne that he is referring to. Yecholah Liot Shvirat Galut Mitzrayim Ve'adarabah V'nitzaltem Et Mitzrayim. So we should be able not only to break the Galut of Mitzrayim, but also when we leave Mitzrayim, to empty out Mitzrayim, to empty out all its physical part and the spiritual part. We're not just taking Mitzrayim we're not just abusing Mitzrayim physically, but also spiritually. We're exhausting Mitzrayim from all its resources. Why? Because Mitzrayim is a place of constraint, a place of limitation, and we're bringing the infinite into the finite, and therefore exhausting all its natural resources that it has, which is the gold and silver of the world, and the spiritual sparks that were there.
So, what difference does it make between asking for it versus just taking it? Like they ask for the jewelry and the stuff before leaving, also asking Hashem, let my people go, and getting His permission, versus just freezing them all and then, you know, leaving with what you put on the boat. We gotta get their permission.
Right. So, it says there are two levels of. Of dealing with the opposition, with the other side. So one level is that you are subduing the other side, okay? You're dominating.
What the other side?
There's two ways of dealing with the other side. When I said the other side, I mean the opposition to Kedusha. So one way is dominating it, and the second way is transforming it. We needed, for example, Lavan to come to Yaakov and tell him, hey, take care of these sparks that you left behind. Esav coming to Yaakov and says, come with me. I want to join your trip. Right? So over here, we needed the Egyptians to say, or like we need a power to say to the Egyptians, go to Yosef, the flow comes from him. Right? That's already a transformation of the opposition. The one who represented the Klippa is admitting that the flow to the world is coming through Yosef. And similarly with the Egyptians, saying, here is our stuff. We're lending it to you, right? Because we need you to elevate it. The clothing, the jewelry, anything that we considered important, and we're giving it to you. And the Jews, on their part, had to make sure that they're doing a complete job. That's why at the plague of darkness, they went into their houses and checked where everything is, and then they made sure that it was done properly. That's where the expression "Vayenatzlu et Mitzrayim." Lenatzel in Hebrew is to abuse, is to take advantage. But what time is it? Okay, we have a few. So it says, "Vehine, hey," it says, "Vehine, maase avot siman lebanim." You know what it means, maase avot? What the forefathers did, what your parents did, it's siman lebanim. It enables you to follow the way, follow the path, and it not just enables you. They give you the power to do it. They're almost like, not just enabling you, but in also encouraging you, giving you the power to do it. So it says, "Kefi shem v'yatzim achzeg v'drush ze, shinyan ze nogia gam b'chol ha'galuyot shel achreze." Whatever, what Yosef did, it's associated, it's connected with all the exiles that came afterwards, ad le'yameinu elu, until this very day, b'galut ha'acharon, the last exile, sh'ha'geulam enu tiyeh davka k'yimei satcha me'et Mitzrayim. This exile, the redemption from this exile will be similar to the way we left Mitzrayim. V'ainyan b'ze, d'ini al derech u'mamad u'matzav hanal etzel Yosef ha-tzadik. We saw what happened with Yosef. Sh'ayagam b'nes yutet kislev. This also took place in the miracle of the 19th of Kislev. V'al derech ze b'kam anisim etzadikim nesiye olam. And similarly with other miracles that took place with Tzadikim, that were the leaders of the world, כמו שכתב רבינו הזקן בגירת הקודש שלו, as the Alter Rebbe wrote in Igirat HaKodesh, in connection with his release, בקשר עם שחרורו מפטרבורג, regarding his release from Petrburg, שהפליע הוויה, he writes these words, הפליע הוויה, Hashem made wonders, והגדיל לעשות, and he did wonders בארץ, in the land, כמו שנתבאר פעם בארוכה, שרבינו הזקן כופל שלוש פעמים, אלת רבי writes three times, ובפרט בעיני כל השרים, and he uses especially in the eyes of all the ministers, and בכל העמים, and all the nation, אשר גם בעיניהם יפלא הדבר, that they himself were wondering why would the Russian government agreed to his release. They're all wondering how is it possible. Even the nations of the world saw it in a physical way. At that time, that obviously the chiddush of the novelty of the 19th of Kislev, that it was the day that Pnimiut HaTorah was officially revealed. The secrets of the Torah were officially revealed. Be'ofen shel havana v'hasaga, in a way of Chabad, in a way of understanding. Be'ofen shel ti'ima al kol panim, to'amei ha'chaim, that you can taste the taste of Shabbat during the week. The taste of Pnimiut HaTorah is the taste of Mashiach. Me'in v'dugma le'gilui ta'amei Torah shel to'otos shel Mashiach. It reminds me that they say, what would be the difference between when Mashiach comes, it says it would be a new Torah be revealed. So what would be the difference between a chosid and a mistagin? We'll both be exposed to the new Torah. So one Mashpia said that the difference will be, the chosid will say, aha, and the mistagin, for him it's going to be a new concept, a new learning. For him it's going to be, wow, a new thing. Well, Chosid will say, aha, okay, now I connect the dots. Now I see what they meant with Atzilus, what they meant, what is Yesod, what is Yosef, what this represents. So that's aha moment, but for the Misnagid, it will be a completely new teaching. So the Rebbe tells us that...
You see what Ein Sof is? You go, oh, that's Ein Sof?
Yeah.
Will it reach that level?
He'll be able to understand it. That's when he says that now there's only the tastings. Now we're doing the taste. Tomei ha'chaim. Einu dugma legilui tamei Torah shebetorot Hashem Mashiach. V'yan b'zeh di'inav shegam lifnei zeh. Even before the time of the Alter Rebbe, hayu geulot me'agaluyot shebin time. There was already times that they went through geulot, redemptions from the exiles they were dealing with. For example, Yavan, what we have in Chanukah, redeemed from the exile of the Greeks, Madai, the exile of Madai, Uparas, Shebazen yichlelet gam ha'geulah b'mei Chanukah. The redemption of Chanukah is included in these redemptions. She'az yishno yan nerot Chanukah she'nan betelim le'olam. The Gemara says that the candles of Chanukah, actually brought in Midrash Tanchuma and the Ramban, he writes that the candles of Chanukah would never be nullified, meaning this mitzvah will continue forever and ever. Why? There are certain mitzvahs certain things that will change, but after Mashiach comes. When it comes to this mitzvah, it's not going to change.
Is it like Purim too? Like Purim and
Hanukkah? Right. Hare adayin lo yaz gilui pnimut haTorah. It says, but nevertheless, the revelation of pnimut haTorah was only revealed to Yechidei Segula, to selected few. Selected few were exposed to the learning of Pnimiut HaTorah, the learning of Chassidut. Kedita beGeret HaKodesh, it says in Geret HaKodesh. Ve'al achat kama v'kama, shelo haya zeh be'ofen shel havana v'hasaga. And even those that were exposed to the teachings of the esoteric part of Torah, it was not done in a way that they completely understand it. Specifically in this bitter last exile, nitna pnimiut haTorah lechol echad miYisrael. Pnimiut haTorah was given to every single Jew, not only to the selected few. V'davka midor ledor mishana leshana umiyom liyom, and every day, starts off with every generation, every year, every day, nitztavenu, we are commanded leharbot belimud zeh, to learn even more from specifically these teachings, the esoteric part of Torah, ubeofen de'afatzat ha'mayot, in such a way that we even spreading it outwards. De'afatzat ha'mayot chutza v'ayinu she'afa b'shadayin en zetor tosho Mashiach. It says, don't get mistaken, it's not yet the teachings of Mashiach, begalu in a revealed way, kim beofen shel te'ima b'lvad, it's only tasting, mikol makom, but nevertheless, al yedei ha'limud beofen shemoser et atzmo le'limud zeh. But if you're learning in such a way that you're giving yourself over to this type of teaching, to this learning, inibati mazo, by tasting it, with this tasting, Yeshlo ad lemala mala chulu. He has something that is now grabbing or grasping that is going all the way to the top. Va'adrava, kivan shekol ha'gilim shilu atidlo ve'et Moshiach tzedekim tluim ma'asinu ve'avotem v'shech zman ha'gilu. It says all the revelations that will be in the times of Mashiach are dependent on what we do in the time of Galut. Meaning we are somewhat designing the future times, the time of Mashiach. So the Alter Rebbe said, all the revelations that will be in the time of Mashiach depended on Maaseinu, on our actions, on our work in the time of exile. V'lod, not only that, Ela shekol gilu'imenu k'rim b'shem sachar b'lvad, all the revelations that will be in the time of Mashiach will be called reward only. Sachar bilvad, reward only for what we did in the time of Galut, the time of exile. Ve'ilu ma'aseinu v'avodatinu ha'davar shegorem u'poel zot. So our actions are causing it to happen. Nimtza, what do we find? Sha'inyan shepoel gilui. Torato shel Mashiach, what is bringing the revelation of the teachings of Mashiach? U'davka atchala v'achana, is the preparation that we do for it. והדוגמה לזאת בזמן הגלות בחושך כפול מחופל, and the, what is the example to it? The time of exile, the time of double and redoubled darkness, על ידי לימוד ומסירת הרצון, in such a way that we're learning, not just learning, but learning with מסירת הרצון, meaning that you give over your רצון, your will, שאז הלימוד הוא באופן שיגעת, and when you give over your will, then your learning is in a way of יגעת, of toiling, as the Gemara says in Megillah, ורק בתור שכר, על זה, just for the reward on Yegia, on toiling in Torah, יהיה אחר כך גילוי טעמי Torah that would lead to the revelation of טעמי Torah. We know that the trap in the Torah is not explained yet. That's a part of Torah that is not yet explained. You have Rabbi Akiva who explained the crowns of the Torah, but טעמי Torah, why there are specific a trap in certain places, we don't know it. But it says it's one of the things that will be revealed beviat Mashiach Tzidkenu, in the time of, when Mashiach will come, shilameda tam kulo, that will teach the entire nation Torah, umitoch arachava veharvacha, in such a way that will be in an abundant way, that the teaching will be that way, and our state, we will be in a state of abundance. כמו שכתב הרמב״ם, את הרמב״ם writes in the laws of מלאכים, the laws of kings, he writes שאז יהיו המעדנים מצויים כאפר. At those days the delicacies will be available as the dust of the earth. וכן תהיה לנו בקרוב ממש, and so it should be to us, speedily in our days, ביתה חישנה, the famous prophecy of Yeshaya, who says ביתה, that it should happen either in its right time, at the appointed time, or achishena, or that we will merit to accelerate the process, that should happen before the appointed time. Lemata ma'asarat vachim, which means down here below in a physical reality, begula amitit v'ashlema, in the complete and true redemption, al yedei Mashiach tzidkenu, through a righteous Mashiach, bekarov mamash, uve'agolo didan. So speedily in our days, and faster than what we can even fathom. Ruchim to you. That's the mind. Then the Rebbe said to sing Podo B'Sholem after the